In this experiment, we are going to investigate single slit diffraction a little deeper. Let's start with a diffractive slit which has 1 mm width. We can see the interference pattern on the wall, indicated by alternating dark and bright spots. Many sources available on the internet explain the observed pattern as the result of interference of infinitely many sources originated from the space between the edges of the slit, according to Huygens' principle. Here is another example from another source, which uses finite number of point sources as an approach to derive the equation. This example derives the equation using phasor diagram. All of these explanations refer to Huygens' principle, which assumes that interfering point sources are the space between the edges, rather than the surface of the edges itself. To determine whether the space or the edges of the slit as the real interfering point sources, we can conduct an experiment using a slit whose edges are not diffractive. If Huygens' principle is correct, then we should still get interference pattern even though the edges of the slit doesn't diffract light. Let's recall from previous video about non-diffractive obstacle which can obstruct incoming light beam without causing it to diffract. If we put two obstacles of this type side by side, we can create a single slit aperture, just like a glass prism here. You can see that this prism is beveled, and the width of the bevel is around 1 mm, similar to the width of the slit that we used in the beginning of this video. If Huygens' principle is correct, then we should get interference pattern similar to the result in our previous experiment. By the fact that we find no interference pattern now, it is hard to escape from the conclusion that interference pattern occurs in single slit experiment doesn't come from the space between the edges. Rather, the interfering light sources originated from the surface of the edges.